Hey BJ. Yeah, everybody know I ain't off that drama. Oh yeah, I like what I started. I'ma tell you right now, I plan on chilling so hard right now. Ain't taking no calls right now. I'm kicking back and I'm lashing up. Hey BJ. It's been a week since you've been gone. You left April 2nd. And well, today isn't technically makes a week. Tomorrow makes a week, but I just want to go ahead and film it today. Today I have a job interview. If you hear people talking in the background, please ignore it. But today I have a job interview for a different place. So yeah, hopefully I get the job. It's been crazy, like, not talking to you, you know? Like, since talking to you has been, like, our daily routine, I know it affects us in, like, a crazy way. But I'ma just, you know, stay positive. That's all I can do. And I hope you stay positive while you're there. But I really, really, truly miss you, like. I just been telling people all the time that June, you hurry up. Like, that's when you graduate from basic training. Like, I just been telling everybody, like, I don't be wanting to talk to nobody but you. And, like, we be on the phone, like, every morning, every night when we going to sleep. I wake up to you being on the phone. Like, that's how serious it is. But I really can't wait until you back, until you're back. I just know it's going to be the best freaking feeling ever. And I can't wait to get your first letter. I'm still waiting on it. Speaking of letter, I can hear the mailman right now. I don't know if you ever wrote me yet and waiting on it to get here, but I can't wait to get your first letter. Yeah, babe, I miss you so much. I can't wait till you're back.
Bless you.
But I don't want to make the first 1 week update too long. I love you and I'll see you in week two. Hey BJ. So today makes week two that you've been in basic training. Everything been all right. I haven't been really talking to people much. I just been like focusing on myself and everything. And today I went to take my drug test for my job. And people, I'm not gonna say what job it is. BJ told me not to tell y'all where I'm gonna be at. Anyways, but yeah, I was in that jump for freaking 2 to 3 freaking hours. Like, it was like a whole new crowd that even came in and I was still there from the other crowd. But But I really do miss you. Like, I really been missing talking to you like crazy. I had sent you a letter last Thursday, and I really hope that you got it. And I can't wait until you write me back. Yeah, like, I just been doing me. I really haven't been talking to nobody. Like, you was the only person I talked to, like, every freaking day, every hour. Like, I just can't wait till you're back, BJ. It's gonna be, like, the best feeling ever. But, yeah. Nothing else really major or anything happened or been going on. But, yeah, I guess it's pretty much it. I'll see you in week 3 to update you again. I love you as always. Hey BJ, it is now week 4, and y'all, it's crazy. Like, as you not think about the time, it just goes by faster, like, without it being a problem. But I've been doing all right. A lot of good things has been happening. One of the things is I've currently been working, you know, so I've been working. Two, a few days ago, I had literally just got 5 letters from BJ, and it all came at the same time. And when I tell y'all, I was like so freaking happy. I was like so freaking ready to read out the letters, but like the letters was like, it was just a lot. It was crazy. Of like everything he was telling me and stuff, it's like a lot he was like going through and stuff, and how much he missed me and stuff. And then the last thing, which was really shocking, and I just knew in my gut something good was gonna happen. Sunday, when I got home from church, I got a phone call from his mom, and she was like, she finna add BJ to the car. And I was really shocked and stuff, because BJ didn't have my number yet. And I didn't like write my number in the first letter. I don't know why. But yeah, I had wrote it in the letter now. But she had added him to the call, y'all. Oh my gosh. It was like the best freaking day ever. Like, it was like the best 30 minutes of my life. The call was like 30 minutes long. And I heard his voice for the first time in like forever, it seems like. But yeah, it was crazy. Like, you could just hear all, like, you just hear all in his voice, like how sad he was and how much he missed everybody and stuff. It was like crazy. I miss you so much, BJ. Like, the time is coming. Like, it's finna be May, and then after May it's gonna be June. But yeah, your time is coming very, very soon, and I'm just ready for all of it. I've been all right, you know, just doing me. I just pray. I've been praying for you like night and day, nonstop, like every day. I don't miss a day without praying for you and stuff. Like, I pray for you more than myself, BJ. So yeah, it's crazy. I really miss you like so much. I mean, it's coming very, very soon. I can't wait to see you. But yeah, you guys, all right, man, I'll see y'all in week 5. So see you later. Hey, BJ, I'm not gonna make this week update long, but it is now week freaking 5. Like, it's like getting so close. Like, I'm so excited. But I've been doing like a lot better, you know. Week 1 compared to now, like week 1 I was just like still upset, you know, not being able to talk to you. But now, like, I learned how to deal with it and stuff, and I learned ways to like help myself feel better and stuff when I'm really thinking about you a lot. I just ordered some, not just, but I recently ordered some pictures to send to you at Basic Training, and they come Thursday, and today is Tuesday. So yeah, I'm looking forward to that, and hope I can get it mailed to you right away. But yeah, week 5 update, your girl is doing good. I'm just ready to hear back from you again, you know. I'm just ready, like, it's crazy. But I'll see you in week 6. Peace. Hey, BJ, I'm looking so freaking rough. Oh my gosh, it is now freaking week 6 update. Whew, week 6, y'all. Time is kind of, it's picking up. We're getting there. Last Thursday, I had got 2 letters from BJ. Got 2 letters from you, BJ. As time, like, is going by, the letters are getting more good, you know. I feel like I gotta sneeze. Hold on. Oh, I know I'm looking rough, by the way. Still got on my pajamas. Anyway, as time going by, the letters are getting better. Because in the beginning, you know, he needed, like, more motivation. And, you know, I just wanted to be there for him and stuff. After I got those 2 letters, I had sent out another letter. And my pictures had came, too. So I had sent him some pictures. So I hope you got those, BJ. I pray that you got those pictures, man, because it was like, it wasn't that small. That was kind of like this, that's kind of like this big, but they all fit in the envelope. I just been trying my best, you know, to keep BJ motivated, you know. That's like the best thing anybody who, you know, is in the military basic training. They just need the motivation and stuff to keep pushing through. And that's what I've been doing, you know. If you really love somebody and they go to basic training or anything like that, like, it would really change you in so many ways. Like, you just realize how much you want to appreciate them more and stuff like that. And you just look back at all the arguments y'all had and think of how silly it was and stuff like that. It really makes you realize a lot of stuff, you know. And it's been like, I feel like it's been like so much time that has passed by, you know, since we talked and everything. And it's just like, it's taking forever. Like, he just need to go ahead and graduate so I can see him. I cannot wait to see you, BJ. Like, I really cannot wait to see you. Week 6 update. I'm still doing all right. It be a few times that I get a little upset, you know. Just have to, like, brush it off, you know. Anybody who watching this, you are going to have, you're going to have moments when you just kind of break down. Not like breakdown, but like it depends on how upset you are. But like, yeah, I had a lot of those, you know, missing him a lot and stuff like that. Like, when you really love somebody and y'all talk to each other on a daily, like before they left, like you was really going to be feeling like some type of way, like seriously. Because me and BJ talked every single day, every hour, every minute, every second. We talked to each other. And I just know it's going to be crazy, like, once we get to do that again. I will see y'all in week 7, guys. This is crazy. Like, we is getting there. We like right there. All right, man. I ain't trying to talk too much. But peace. I'll see y'all in week 7 update. Hey, BJ. It is now week 7. And y'all, we is like gonna be there. Gotta go to work at 11 o'clock. It's 10:11 right now. But yeah, so I'm just gonna go ahead and record this update. I had got a call from BJ. It was Sunday. I had got a call from BJ, y'all. And it's crazy because I normally get off at 8, but for some reason that day, it was slow and stuff. And I got off at like 7 something. And like, he caught me like at the right time because like I wasn't doing nothing. I was like at the store and I was finna like go home. And y'all, he caught me and I was like so freaking happy. And then when I got home, he ended up like FaceTiming me. And y'all, when I first saw him for the first time in like freaking a month. It's been like a month since I freaking saw him. When I first saw him, like, I just started crying. Like, I was just like crying real hard and stuff because it was just like crazy and stuff. It was exciting. But yeah, I was so glad to see him. That legit has been the best day ever yet. But yeah, I just put a letter in the mail to him because I just got one from him yesterday. But week update 7, y'all. Since the day he called, I just been like, I don't know how to describe it. Ever since the day he called, I just been like to myself. Really haven't been talking to anybody. I just been like, just doing me. So yeah, I just been to myself, you know. I barely been going places. Like, it's all this time he been gone. Like, I barely been out of house, like, besides work. I just, like, be home and stuff. But, yeah, this really got me, I don't even know. Still missing him like crazy, y'all. It's still kind of hard, but not as hard as it was, like, day one. It's still kind of hard. I'm just ready to get to talk to him. But, yeah, today, his graduation is going to be here before I know it. So, I'm just keep on moving, pushing. I was glad to see him. Like, he was very positive and stuff and very humble. Who was on the phone and he seemed like everything was going good and everything, so I could tell that he was feeling a lot better about everything. But yeah, I did this video too long. Oh yeah, I look so rough right now, I know. Week update 7, and I will see y'all in week update 8. Peace. Hey BJ, week update freaking 8. Week update 8, y'all. Week 8. Man, oh man. Well, yesterday was kind of a rough day for me, you know. I had to, you know, I called BJ's mom and we had talked. Like, we had a nice, deep conversation. Like, she was there, you know, to give me advice, comfort me and stuff, you know. And, like, she's just, like, the best, like, adult to talk to, I swear. Like, she just give you, like, the best advice. Like, she really speaks her mind. Like, it's crazy. But, y'all, I've been alright. It's really just the same, you know. Just me still. I'm super impatient. Like, the day, even though it's, like, really close, I'm still super impatient. Like, I'm just ready for the actual day to get here. Like, when you really love somebody, you would just, it would really drive you crazy. Like, really love BJ. And when you really love somebody, you wouldn't do, like, anything for them. I feel that way, and I know he feel that way for sure. I've been blowing his messages up. I've been sending him video diaries, messages. Yeah, BJ, I'm going to see you in 2 weeks, in 2 days, in a few hours, in minutes. But yeah, 2 weeks, 2 days, man, is when I'm see you. And, like, I am going to cry. I bet I'm going to cry, like, once I see you. This is going to be crazy. Y'all like my watch? Yep, bae got that for me. This is, like, his first gift to me. And I love this watch, y'all. Bling. I know I look better now than my other videos, my other clips, because I'm finna go to the mall. My brother, my big bro, he finna take me to the mall. And I'm actually finna get something for BJ for when I see him. So, yeah, I'm finna go to the mall and be waiting for him to pull up. It's Tuesday, so this was week 8 update. Still holding strong, y'all. Still holding strong, but he gonna be home soon. And I'm ready. It's about that time. See y'all week update 9. Peace. Hey, BJ. It is now the week 9. Update. Whew. So week 10 will actually, next Tuesday will actually make week 10, and that's gonna be the day before his graduation. Well, before a family day. So I'm gonna be back for next Tuesday. But week 9 update, y'all. I had got a call. I got another call from BJ Sunday, and I was, like, literally at work when he called me, and, like, I had to pick up. I knew that it was him calling me, and it's crazy because I had a feeling he was gonna call me that day. But yeah, I had got a call from him Sunday. He had, like, 30 free minutes, so he, like, we was on the phone for some good time, and then he said he was gonna call the rest of his family and stuff. So, but yeah, so I was able to talk to him. I was really happy. I had got another letter from him yesterday in the mail, but it was, like, today is June 4th. Yeah, today is June 4th, and the letter was from May 21st. I think it was May 20th, and I'm now getting a June 4th. Like, yeah, that's how late it be. And, like, in the letters he'd be like, you need to send me some more letters, blah 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 blah. Like, I be sending him letters and stuff. I don't know if he get my slate or is it just me that I get his slate, but it's, like, I'm feeling, like, a whole lot better. Like, now that it's, like, really literally right there, I'm feeling much better, you know. Time has been picking up, and I just can't wait. Like, I just remember when he first left, and I was just so freaking drained. Like, just needed to talk to him and stuff. But now I literally see him in, like, 7 more days, 7-8 more days. And this is crazy. Like, I've been doing his Snapchat streets every day for like 64. I think today we'll make like the 64th day. I've been on his Snapchat streets, man. I've been sending him video diaries. I've been messaging him like crazy. Everybody who I talk to, I talk about him. This is what it would make you do. Like, I really miss him too. I've been holding our relationship down, and I just can't wait to see him. It's gonna be like so freaking fun. I'm going to be doing a vlog family day, and I'm going to, well, I don't know if I should do a family day and graduation. I might do it. I might put the same thing in the same video. So I might put family day and graduation day in the same video. All right. I know from day one, BJ, he was like, he was ready to come back and stuff. He was in a lot of pain, but now he's a lot better. He's stronger. He's more humble. And you can tell all of that, you know, through the phone calls and the letters and stuff, the transformation. And I'm just really super, super proud of BJ. Like, seriously. Man, Georgia weather is not playing. It is so freaking hot. Yeah, basic training is a serious experience. It's a crazy experience, but it's a good experience at the same time. I'm saying it's like I've been there. I just personally know. I don't know. I feel like I understand what it's like. But, yeah, I made this update too long. I will see y'all again for week 10 update, which is the day before family day, the day before I see BJ. I will be back. Can't wait to see BJ. Peace. BJ. OMG, y'all. It is now freaking week 10. It's Tuesday. I see BJ tomorrow. And when I tell y'all, I just been lit all freaking morning. Like, this is like a celebration. Well, first, I want to start by saying, BJ, I am so freaking proud of you. Like, I knew you can do it, like, from the beginning. I know the beginning was tough and stuff, but you, the main thing that's important is that you got through it, you pushed through it. And you just kept going, you know, like no matter what. And I'm super proud of you, baby. My gosh, I can't believe I see you tomorrow. And today is made 71 days that you've been in basic training. And well, 71 days that I've been doing your streets. That's how I kind of caught up. I mean, I kept up with the count. So this is like super crazy. I had got another call from BJ Sunday. So like, that's basically what Fort Jetson, I guess, give out, like, let them call people, like, Sundays. Because those are the only days that I got calls from him. I said I got about four calls, probably. But I see BJ tomorrow, y'all. my arm got tired. But this has been some super, a long freaking 9 weeks, 10 weeks, like. Well, technically, it's like 9 weeks, but I just count today's 10th week. But, and y'all see me in the background. What's up? It has been some long 9 weeks, y'all. Like, it's crazy. Like, basic training is like, if you have a boyfriend or girlfriend going out to basic training, make sure you support them and send them as many letters as you can. Because I swear BJ was getting on my nerves. And these letters talking about, you're not sending enough letters. Keep sending letters. I was sending letters. I don't know if it's because he was getting it late or stuff. Like, I had to, like, send extra letters. But I don't know how soon he was getting my letters. I just know I was getting his letters late. But if you have a boyfriend or girlfriend that's going to basic training, make sure you support them. Remain loyal, of course. And, send them letters. Just hold it down. Motivate them. Do everything you can to keep them motivated and happy. And yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it. Like, there's nothing much to it. And just be patient. Patient is key. Time is going to go by. Don't worry about the time at all. just keep yourself doing occupied. I say doing occupied. That don't even make sense. Keep yourself occupied doing something. And yeah, I see BJ tomorrow. Tomorrow is family day, and then the next day is his graduation day. So I'm going to see him family day and graduation day. Yep. And I will be doing a vlog of family day and graduation day. So y'all stay tuned for that. Congrats, baby. I love you. And I'll see y'all in this video. Peace. Living room floor, play Nintendo.